I realized that people's connection to Stones is very, very deep.
And it should be, because Stone's restaurant under the viaduct down by the Vinegar Works has been a Marshalltown mainstay since 1887. There were a couple of years recently when it was closed.
Indeed, but as we see in tonight's Cruising for Comfort Food, the legendary eatery has been resurrected, and our own Steve Carlin stopped by today. See?
Yeah, and Kevin, it was a satisfying stop. I'm still pretty full. As you said, the place is a Marshalltown mainstay, and new owner Steve Badger is doing his best to do justice to Stone's storied past while taking the restaurant in a new direction. Stone's restaurant is bouncing to a brand new beat.
I like the quaintness, the oldness, the antiquiness of it.
Sure, it's still under the viaduct down by the Vinegar Works, right in the middle of the Marshalltown rail yard.
The quality of the food is kind of like we remember when we were kids.
But after 120 years of continuous operation, Stone's originally opened in 1887, it closed in 2007. Only to be reopened in 2009 by a big-time music lover and an M-Town native.
It's wonderful because what Steve Badger's done is resurrected an institution.
Well, it really started with the music.
Steve Badger, a major audiophile, modeled every aspect of the new Stones with the music now played over the sound system firmly in mind.
It's swing, it's rockabilly. Jump blues, boogie woogie.
Steve says once he selected the music and the mood he wanted to set in here, setting up the menu was simple.
It's food that was popular in the 1940s and 50s, home-cooked meals.
Steaming from scratch, home cooking like chicken and noodles, a huge hot beef, pan-fried chicken, steak sandwiches, and much more.
Stone's has always been famous for its desserts, and I've been true to that.
True in that they're all baked right here, but to traditionalists, with one sizable exception, there's no daily mile-high lemon chiffon pie, seen here in a previous News Channel 8 story from 1999.
It's a strange, fickle pie.
The restaurant business can be strange and fickle, too. But Steve Badger is convinced he is finding the right rhythm at the newly reopened Stones.
The most common reaction that I'm getting from customers, whether they're from Marshalltown or anywhere in the state of Iowa or even elsewhere, is that they're just happy that it's open again.
People are happy. No daily mile-high lemon chiffon pie, but they are planning to serve it with Thanksgiving dinner for an extra special Turkey Day treat. Now, Steve says that pie is just too difficult to make, and it's too difficult to get right. Some people say it tastes fine. Other people say, it's no good.
Fickle customers. You ate there today. Did you find a suitable substitute for
Kevin. I did. I really, really like key lime pie, and Stone's key lime is very good. Steve once lived in South Florida, and what he does is he has the lime juice shipped in from Miami, so the pie is really, really good. And by the way, I'm going to do a couple more of these, so I need some more ideas, so send them in to KCCI.com.
Sounds like a good idea. Okay. Thank you, Steve.
You bet.